Hey there, Mr. Reddit here. Welcome back to another episode of r/EntitledParentStories. Our first story we'll be reading today, Karen calls cops on Amazon driver. After that, entitled dad and entitled mom try to get me kicked out of movies for my seat. After that, entitled parent has no courtesy. After that, I almost got in trouble with a manager I've never worked under. And after that, make me do the bulk of the work? Have fun repeating class. Now Karen told me if we get 1,000 likes on this video, she won't try to get anyone kicked out of the movies for an entire week. So please smash that like button. And if you're new, subscribe and turn on notifications for new stories from Reddit every single day. And huge shout out to our newest official channel member, Portkiss D Ace. Thank you so much for supporting the channel. Become a member today and I'll give you a shout out in an upcoming video. Karen calls cops on Amazon driver. This just happened yesterday and I am still trying to gather my thoughts. I was driving a route that was given to me when I came into a neighborhood where there were some cones on the road close to the curb to let other drivers know that kids were playing outside. These cones were the small regular orange ones with a light at the top of it to make them more noticeable. The kids were playing in the yard and it was very big to run around in without running into the streets. They were nowhere close to the road at all. Despite what people have said about Amazon drivers, we usually do follow the rules since we have people at the warehouse, including Amazon, watching us. I was driving a little below the speed limit since I saw the cones on the road and wanted to be respectful. Apparently, this wasn't slow enough for the mother who was outside watching the kids. She decided to start walking to my van and for her safety, I started slowing down so I didn't hurt her since she was getting closer to my van. As she is walking, she is yelling at me. Entitled mom, slow down. There are kids playing outside and your reckless driving could hurt someone. Me, no, I was driving the speed limit. Plus, your kids are nowhere near the road. I can see your cones and know that the kids are playing.
I don't care if they are in the road or not. You need to be more considerate of other people than yourself.
This carried on for a few more minutes, me telling to her and her yelling to me. I didn't want to deal with her anymore, so I started driving off. She decided to get in front of my van in the middle of the road to stop me from driving. I yelled at her to move and she put her hands on her hips to say,
I'm not going anywhere.
I didn't want to deal with this crazy lady anymore and needed to deliver more packages. So I turned my van to the left and then she moved to the left. I turned my van to the right and again, she turned to the right. At this point, I am a little past her driveway. So I started backing up and she started yelling at me more.
I know your job is hard, but you need to listen to me.
Me, please just go away.
You need to stop driving so fast.
At this point, the father comes outside and tells the mother to calm down and stop yelling. As I am backing up, I barely touch one of the cones on the ground. The father starts yelling about how I destroyed his cones and how expensive they are and tells me how I owe them money for the cone. I park my van and the mother is extremely close to my van now. I open my door to look at the damage and the mother jumps in front of my door and then starts crying that I hit her with my van.
You hit me with your van.
I can't believe you hit me.
Entitled father.
I can't believe you just hit my wife. I'm calling the cops on you. You're not going anywhere.
I get back in my van and call my dispatcher to let them know what was going on so I didn't get into trouble for being late to my next drop. Our deliveries are time-based and we can get into trouble if we sit too long. The police arrive and they come up to me and ask about what happened. The father and mother jumps in first. Entitled mom.
This man was speeding down the road at a high rate and I tried yelling at him to slow down. He almost hit one of my kids. Then he got mad at me telling him to slow down and reversed his van and destroyed our cones. Then he slammed his door into me, hurting me in the process.
Entitled father.
I paid a lot of money for those cones, and this guy destroys them all because he got mad at my wife. The cones are to protect the kids from drivers like him.
He needs to pay for Mike Holmes. Me, you both are lying. I was driving a very slow speed when the mother decided that I was going too fast and stopped me in the middle of the road. Then, when I tried to leave, I accidentally touched one of the cones, not even damaged, and the father started yelling at me and called you guys. As for hitting her, she jumped in front of my door as I opened it, I assume to falsify her getting hit. The officers looked at the cones and see that there is no damage to it, and then went to the mother and told her, "Police officer,
you know it's illegal in the state of Texas to stop a moving vehicle in the middle of the road. You are not allowed to block any kind of traffic. If anyone has to pay anything, it will be you paying a ticket."
I asked the police if I may go, and he said yes. I really don't like losing time and didn't want to be there longer than I needed to. I don't know what ended up happening to the mother or father, but I wish I could have remembered their address just so I could put a little piece of paper on their door that reads, "Ha ha." Next we've got, Entitled Dad and Entitled Mom Try to Get Me Kicked Out of the Movies for My Seat. So recently, Disney released its newest movie, Frozen 2, into theaters. Now, ever since the original Frozen movie came out, I was in love with Frozen. I loved everything about it. So when Disney released the trailer, I was over the moon. I had immediately ordered tickets for me and a friend and patiently waited for the movie to come out. This is the interaction that took place while my friend and I were seated in the movie theater. Me and friend, quietly chatting while waiting for the movie to start. Entitled Mom, Entitled Dad, Kid 1 and Kid 2 walk over to us. Entitled Dad:
Excuse me, girls, but I believe you are in our seats.
Friend gets out ticket to check. Sure enough, we were in the right seats. Friend: I'm sorry, but these are the right seats. Maybe you guys are seated in a different row. Entitled Mom:
No, these are the right seats. Can I see your tickets?
Friend hands over tickets. Entitled Mom looks at them and puts them in her pockets.
How about this? We'll sit here and you guys can go move to those seats over there. After all, there are four of us and my husband and I want our kids to have a pleasant experience while we're on vacation.
Keep in mind, I bought tickets for the movie the moment they were being sold. So naturally, I'd have pick at good seats. Also, I live in a state that is a hotspot for tourists, so I've had to deal with several entitled tourists such as these. Me: Once again, ma'am, we're sorry, but these seats are ours. Besides, if I'm correct, there are two other people sitting on both sides. Entitled Dad:
Girls, you're being unreasonable. Where are your parents?
Me: They didn't come along.
So you two are seeing a movie that is clearly out of your age range?
Frozen is rated PG-13. My friend is 16 and I am 15. However, due to our faces, we can appear to be 11 and sometimes 10. Friend: No, we're old enough to see this movie.
I don't believe you are. You two stay right here. I'm going to get a worker.
About 2 minutes pass and soon, Entitled Mom comes running back with a person who worked at the theater. Worker: Is there a problem?
Yes, these two girls are in our seats and refuse to move.
Me: That's not what happened.
They are also under 13 and are here without an adult to accompany them.
Worker looks at me and friend. Do you both have your tickets? Entitled Mom seemed very smug, thinking that we would be removed from the room. However, I bought the tickets on my phone and chose the seats. On the Fandango app, when you order tickets and choose your seats, it allows you to see which seats you got. Me takes out phone and shows seat numbers. Also, if you don't believe me about my age, look at this. I showed him my school app, which, when logged into, shows what grade you're in and your birthday. See, I am 15 and I'm in the 10th grade. Now, if you'll excuse me, my friend and I are trying to enjoy the movie which I had bought tickets for a few weeks ago. The worker looked at Entitled Mom and Entitled Dad and asked them for their tickets. When they gave him the tickets, the worker kicked them out. I don't know why, but apparently they had snuck in using tickets from an earlier showing. They probably got them out of the trash or found them on the floor. I learned this from the worker after the movie. All in all, me and my friend enjoyed the movie and had a great time. Of course, the time wasn't ideal because of the Entitled Mom and Entitled Dad, but knowing that they didn't see the movie that day
brought a smile to my face. Next we've got, entitled parent has no courtesy. So the entitled parent of my story is the worst kind of them all. It's the kind you can't get away from because it's my own mother. Today we went over to my gran's apartment for lunch. A thing to note is that in my country, it's common to have maids, but my grandparents and my family until recently don't have any. This is important for later into the story. My grandmother is very active in the church, so there was an event today and no one else wanted to go, so I went instead. Before heading to the event, I ordered a pizza for the family because no one wanted to cook. The event lasted for about 1.5 hours, mostly just waiting around for the priest to show up and chatting with my grandmother's friends. Once it finished, we packed up and headed back to her place. Since we took so long, everyone else ate already, and it was just me and her left eating at the table. After we finished, she was the only one cleaning. I tried to help, but she insisted I didn't. Meanwhile, my mom was sitting at the sofa, not moving. Mind you, they left a bit of a mess as well. Now, this is where the no maids comes into play. For a good 9 months, we only had a cleaning lady come on weekends. At first, I was the one cleaning the house and the dishes, and we would have the laundry done on the weekends. I soon got tired of this because my mom was a mess. It would come to a point where she would leave plates, cups, and utensils in the sink, bedside table, dining table, anywhere she could put them really, all unwashed for days, sometimes weeks. Her laundered clothes would be stacked on chairs and the side of her bed. She would never sweep her room or wipe any of the surfaces. She had dogs that just left and would let their poop accumulate in the backyard. Mind you, she would never walk the dogs at all, and one of them is a lab that was wildly untrained and out of control. She even bit my dog, but that's a story for another time. And these dogs managed to go from fat and fluffy to skinny little things because she forgot to feed them. Basically, she was operating as if we still had people to pick up after her. Whenever I would lecture her about it, she would say, "Those aren't mine. I didn't use those." Or when she couldn't use that excuse, "Don't worry, I'll get to it." We got into a huge argument because she didn't want to even look for new maids and stated, "Well, we can just clean the house ourselves." The point was, she couldn't even clean after herself. I realized that during the time we didn't have maids, she would spend more and more time at my grandmother's house. All those times my mother didn't come home while we were maidless, this is what she was doing to her. She was leaving her 65-year-old mom to clean by herself while she relaxed on the sofa watching TV. She basically had a free maid to cook and clean after her. This was probably going on for the longest time, and I couldn't fathom how someone could just leave their mother to do all the work. It was one thing to be lazy in your own home, but in someone else's? My grandmother afterwards started folding clothes, so I started helping her out. Meanwhile, my mom is still relaxing on the couch. When it got really late, like 12, my sister wanted to leave as she was the one driving. My mom took forever to get up. My sister got so upset she left. So what does my mom do? She then asks my gran for a glass of water when she was literally 5 steps away from the kitchen. After a while, I told my mom to hurry up because sister was waiting for her, and it looked to me like she was taking her sweet time. She then snapped with a, "Yeah, wait, my foot is wet." When she was done, she was still looking around, not caring about how long she was taking. When we finally left the condo 15 minutes later, we went down and had to walk and look for my sister a bit because she moved the car. When we got in, my mom threw my sister's bag out of her way so she could sit. My sister's laptop was in the backpack, and of course, my sister is mad and says, "What the heck? Don't throw my things. My laptop is in there. Hand me my laptop now." Mom is huffing and shoves the bag to my sister. My sis hadn't put the car on neutral, so I tell her to give it to me so I can check it while she drives. After I make sure it's okay, my mom asks for the laptop and she shoves it back into my sister's bag. She's still upset for no reason. I can tell because of the way the laptop thuds when it's tossed into the bag, and I can hear her zip the bag roughly. She doesn't even apologize and huffs and puffs in the back seat. I proceed to drown her out with rap music. This is the other entitled parent that I think receives little attention and exposure. The kind that believes they don't need to have basic courtesy because
we're family. And when you live with someone, it's obvious you'll see them at their worst.
Her words. It's the kind that chirps away at you every day with the small things they do because they can't empathize with anyone but themselves. Next we've got,
I almost got in trouble with a manager I've never worked under. So a few months ago, I stopped working at a large chain retail / grocery store. I had worked there for around 2 years. They don't necessarily have a set uniform. Each department wears something slightly different, but still with the store logo. Sometimes if you're just filling in or a new starter or temp without uniform, you can just wear smart clothes, but still with a name tag. Cut to earlier today. I had just been to an interview, so I was wearing somewhat smart clothing, blouse and black trousers, and had popped into said store for some groceries on my way home. I'm only planning on getting a few things, so I don't take a basket. I'm a bit of a neat freak when it comes to stores, so as I was looking for products, I'd also straighten the shelves a bit. You can't tell me nobody else does this. Suddenly, a middle-aged woman approached me and asked where she could find hemp milk. Me. Oh, sorry, I don't work here, but I believe it's in aisle 24 or 26. Her, already annoyed.
Listen, I've had a busy day, and I don't have time for your games. I can see you straightening shelves. You work here. Now, take me to the hemp milk. It's for my daughter's husband. He's got a milk allergy, and I just want some hemp milk.
Me. I understand, but I don't work here. Her. Loudly, obviously irate.
Stop messing with me. I've seen you working here. I just witnessed you straightening the shelves. I've told you I've had a busy day. Now take me to the milk so I can go home.
Me. I honestly don't know where it would be. I'm sorry, but I need to get home myself. I move around her to carry on with my day, but as I do so, a manager I don't recognize walks down the aisle. The lady screams at him about me not helping her. I turn to him to explain that I don't work there, but before I can say anything, she's shouting and pointing at me, and there are customers around us watching what's going on. The manager is obviously new to the store and is likely embarrassed at the other customers looking at us, so asks the lady and I if we could come to the back of the store. This is normal. There's a couple of security rooms at the rear of the store for interviewing irate customers and staff that have broken rules, lost money, etc. I try to explain through her shouting that I don't work there, but follow along anyway. The manager asks the lady to wait in one room whilst he opens the door to the other one next to it and waves me inside. Before I can speak, he starts saying that as a new starter, I should be trying to make a good impression on the company, and that I can expect to be fired for ignoring and being rude to a customer like that. Before I've entered, one of the supervisors I used to know well comes into the hallway the rooms are on. It connects the shop floor to the colleague toilets and sees me. He immediately starts chatting, asking how I am, etc. He then realizes I'm going into a security room and questions it. I explain that a customer thinks I'm being a rude employee and that I haven't yet been able to get a word in edgeways to explain to this manager that I don't work here. The old supervisor immediately starts laughing at the predicament, saying that I left months ago, and the manager, still holding the door, flushes bright red with embarrassment. He starts apologizing profusely to me, stating that he's new here and hasn't had a chance to meet the colleagues properly. He even offers me vouchers. Luckily, I'm in pretty good spirits and laugh it off. Poor guy seemed stressed beyond belief. I left to go to the shop floor as he went in to speak to the customer, so I don't know how she took the news, but hopefully he came out alive. Next we've got,
make me do the bulk of the work? Have fun repeating class, and a little more. I am what you would call a mature student. I'm a mother, and this class was 85% fresh out of high school students. This story takes place in a class that is required in order to get a degree. At the beginning of the semester, my instructor assigned partners for several large assignments due throughout the semester. This was new to me, since my other classes never did this, but this professor was new, and I figured it was to save time and marking. There were 4 major assignments due. At first, my partner, Sarah, not real name, was great in the first project. She did her half and gave it to me in a timely manner so I could add her information to mine.
I'm kind of a perfectionist, and she didn't mind. I thought we were good. But by midway through the term, I kept getting messages she was busy or didn't have enough time to complete her part. I'm pretty laid back, so while it did irritate me, I figured I could help her and did most of her half. Side note, I'm friends with the ladies in her dorm, and one roommate is my cousin. I went out for a drink with some of them one night, and the more they drank, the more they started talking about Sarah and being annoyed with her. Apparently, Sarah was going out to party almost every night, and when she returned, was loud. She never cleaned up after herself and often brought back random people. My cousin at this point said she was bragging about getting a free ride in most of her classes that required partner work. All she had to do was come up with a poor excuse that was all, "Woe is me," and her partners fell for it. My cousin pitied them and didn't think it was fair. She didn't know we were partners in this class. This upset me, but I didn't say anything. Third major project came, and sure enough, she made excuses. I gave her a lot of ways to make up time, adjusting my schedule to hers, willing to meet her at the library in the evenings and weekends, offering tips for time management, and nope, still with excuses. Third project received great marks too. Okay, to revenge. The final project is worth 45% of the grade. It makes up for a final exam and pretty much a make or break assignment for grades. I was done with her. A week before it was due, I still gave her the benefit of the doubt, and she pretty much shot me down. Told me I was such a big help to a fresh student, and she will do what she can to help, but please don't expect a miracle. By this time, I pretty much had the project done by me 100%. I scheduled a meeting with the professor with documents to show her of how she had never helped. I gave her copies of my email exchanges, text messages, and her admitting she didn't do anything to contribute. But if I was so kind enough to add her name to the assignment because I am her partner after all. I told the professor that I have been carrying the bulk of the work on projects, and while I understand Sarah is adjusting to university life, I don't find it fair if she got marks on this final project when I've done it myself. In short, I was allowed to hand it in under myself, and Sarah received an email stating she had a week to hand in the assignment on her own. I blocked her number and left email messages unopened. Also, I informed her roommates to keep documented evidence of her skirting her responsibilities to hand into the office and informed her other partners on her behavior and how she treated me. In the end, she failed the assignment and pretty much the class. She was kicked out of her dorm. Surprise inspection found things she shouldn't have had and failed another major assignment in another course. Her partner is an acquaintance of mine. She was later kicked out in the following semester for handing in plagiarized work. And shoutouts to our regenerals of the day. Moonlight, Jesse Spider, Hey It's Baby Girl, and Josh Charles. Become tomorrow's regenerals by leaving as many re's as you can in the comments below.